If you can hear me, if anyone can hear this, we made a documentary and we are in Norway now and the entire country is trying to stop us from releasing this film.
I am bound by God to tell the truth, okay? I made a promise to God. From this moment forward, after September 11th, after I saw people with ash on them and body parts on them and rushing away from this horror, it was too much for me. And I decided from that moment on, I'm always going to tell the truth. You're never planning on doing any story because you want to cover up the fact that Bergen police are torturing people, starving people, and terrorizing people. The statistics that are out about Norway are not only a lie, it's all smoke and mirrors. It's all an outrageous cover story. They torture and terrorize people into not telling what's going on here. So everybody in the world thinks it's the most perfect place on earth when it's actually a living nightmare. This is not going to stand.
When this gets out, it's going to kill tourism.
The whole world's going to find out whether you do the story or not.
Don't you have to ask permission to
be filming
inside the building of a company?
This is a newspaper agency, so
yeah.
Up over there. And you guys make your, entire living off documenting things, recording people, taking pictures, so forth and so on. So we've spoken to them before, and it has not been indicated that there's any concern.
No, but I think I have to clear it with my boss anyway.
Okay, that's fine. But we're showing you videotape material that's confidential, so.
Necessarily need to get out before we have printed it.
And that way we're not involved with anything else. We just need a television.
And I'll get a pen.
Okay, great.
Just sit.
What is your occupation?
Answer.
You probably think you got everything figured out. There are the news there. If we continue to face this kind of discrimination, because we are artists and all we want to do is make our movie. And we're not going to accept this kind of treatment. It's 6:35 p.m., Tuesday, April 24th. End of video casting diary speech. Does my name sound real?
We're getting nowhere with this guy.
Every move that he makes, it means something.
Why do you do this? Are you going to kill everyone who is here?
Back to one. Everyone back up.
Hvis du ikke fjerner det bildet, lover jeg. Jeg går rett til politiet med en gang.
Have fun. Enjoy yourself, okay? Okay.
This program contains shocking and often disturbing images. Viewer discretion advised.
Okay, you're too stiff. Tip her back. Honey.
Pushed.
go over there. I'm going over there.
Go for it.
All the way.
Oh God.
Continue.
Were you nervous while you were doing actual scenes? A little?
A little. It was better than I thought.
Falling in love is such an easy thing to do. Birds can do it, we can do it. Let's stop talking, let's get to it. Let's fall in love.
You know, let you rehearse a scene and go over it again and again.
And when we filmed a scene on the boat, it looked so real that people thought the young actress actually did something on the boat. Well, interview everyone on the movie set that day, and they will all confirm it was innocent.
Väpnade politistyrkor omringet i eftermiddag DNB Nords filial i centrum av Bergen. Politiet trodde banken var utsatt för ett väpnat rån. Flere vittner hadde sett personer med finlandshetter og våpen inne i bygningen, og politiet rykket rutinemessig ut med store styrker. Etter hvert viste det seg imidlertid at det foregikk en filminnspilling I bankens lokal, men hverken banken eller filmcrewet hadde varslet politiet, og nå kan resultatet bli bøter.
We must have done a good job in there.
Yeah, it was real. Skilled, man. It was
Are you okay?
Without permission.
You have?
Yeah, go back. Okay, go back into the storm. Hide. Go back. No, we'll have permission. Let him arrest you.
So let me get this straight. You want me to violate his God-given civil rights? That's one of the benefits of being a judge, Mr. Rice. I can pretty much do whatever I want. Hello?
Oh, my God. With the movie? Cool.
What? I'm auditioning. 23.
For certain actors in the film, any friends you can.
We are your story, and we would just like to comment from you.
People think that everything we film looks so real, so vivid and intense, that they don't believe it was faked.
Film here in Bergen. What are your dreams and aspirations? Everyone should have one talent. What's yours?
Handball.
And it's gonna run on Anacoa. Okay.
This is going down one way or another. You want to be on the right side of
you son of a bitch.
Okay, so if there was grand jury investigation. Do you think I could discuss it with one of its targets? I think your back is to the wall. I think right now you will say or do anything to get out of the mess you were in.
Our investigation determined that girls as young as 12 years old are arrested and put through the ringer and possibly videotaped in a private cell before they're charged with a crime.
To be honest with you, I'm sick of this conversation.
No.
Yeah, because you talk so much, you talk all the time, you keep repeating the same thing.
How much have I repeated? What have I repeated?
I've told you that this is a story we're going to look into. And that is something you can respect or not respect.
Creepy, disgusting things over the monitor as you're on videotape. They're naked, young, underage girls, naked, being videotaped. I'm sorry, I have to say, you know, these police officers, some of them, you know, that are responsible for this, they're pedophiles, they're monsters. People in the cells, please help me, screaming and pleading. One of the girls said she needed an ambulance. She was in severe distress, screaming down the hallway. I didn't know what to do. I'm like, what the hell? Through the hallway, as the guards go by, and threats of rape are echoed through the hallway. And, they come in with mace. They come in and brutalize you. They beat the shit out of me. Attacked me on many occasions, both in the police station, both outside on the street, again and again and again. And they threatened to do a whole lot worse, and they planned to do a whole lot worse. Okay? But it's only because it's, you know, someone that they came up against, someone that can deal with it, that is not scared and not intimidated. I mean, I went through September 11th. Do you think some police brutality is going to scare me? Not when 6,000 people die in front of your eyes. Then police brutality doesn't scare you. Then you feel obligated to tell the truth if something horrible is happening. And something is very horrible happening in this case, and they're covering it up, and I'm asking you, please don't cover it up. I'm asking you, please, to report this story, report all the facts, and tell the world what is going on here. Because I know it's not everyone in Norway, and I know everyone in Norway doesn't know what's going on here, and there's a lot of good people here. You know, I know that. There's very good people that aren't horrible, they aren't monsters, you know, and they need to know what's going on here.
Yeah. As I told you, this is a story that we're going to look into. That I can promise you.
Are you worried they're going to put you in solitary confinement and torture you if you do the story?
Well, if that is what you think.
No, I'm asking you. I'm strictly asking a question, because I can understand that it's a pretty serious threat for the police to put over people. Before someone's even charged with a crime, you're a reporter, you've talked to a lot of people. That's what they do here? Before you're even charged with a crime, before a judge says you're guilty, they videotape you naked? They have a camera trained on you on the toilet 24/7? They won't let you have a shaver, they won't let you brush your teeth, they won't let you wash your hands, they won't give you food. Torture camps in Iraq do not treat their war prisoners like this, Tor. The people aren't allowed toilet paper even. I mean, the camera doesn't get covered up? What if you have toilet paper, they can't see everything, and the sick monsters that are at the police station watching this, getting some kind of awful thrill out of it, they can't see enough if there's toilet paper. we're not just shocked. I mean, people ignored the situation with our science fiction movie being shut down and all of those problems. That's a different story. That was a fiction movie. We were filming a fantasy movie. You know, that a lot of people don't care, okay, whether it got shut down or not. We don't really care, you know, it's not our concern. This is a different story. This is a much more serious situation. They are torturing people.
FBI?
Hello, is this the FBI field office in Washington, D.C.? The videotape showing this violent police attack, they have not given back to me. They will not comment on it. And I just contacted the police station, and they said the officer or the police lawyer that I had spoken to doesn't exist. Bergen Central Police Station.
We don't have any Hammarsland in the central.
There has been something that seems like a murder in Bergen Police Station. And for our crime section, that is the top priority, which means that there are several stories on hold. This is one of them.
Okay, so you're saying the story's on hold because of the murder.
I have told my crime reporters to look into this story and see what this is.
Okay, so what you're saying is this story is on hold because of the murder?
Yes.